These instructions will outline how to help you maintain your Supercell for optimal long-term performance.
Do you love your Supercell, but when you want to turn it off with your remote, it doesn't work? You press and press and press, and the system just does not turn off? We have a fix for you.
The reason for this remote problem? High levels of electromagnetic interference, or EMI, in the work environment causes communication issues between the receiver and the remote. Obstructions and distances can interfere with the remote's radio frequency signals. Common sources of interference include distance. The ideal distance is 50 feet from the supercell. Obstructions. Walls, benches, and other machines can reject or absorb the signal. Electromagnetic interference, or EMI. Machines, LED lamps, and other electronic devices may create an interference in the signal. So let's get started. Please note, all electrical wiring must be performed by a qualified, licensed electrician.
First step is to unplug our unit and make sure we are safe. The next step is using a screwdriver to open your starter cover. You'll loosen the screws until they're loose, but they won't come out of the cover. And then once they're loose, you just pull the cover off. And on Supercell 1s, the 20 amp Supercell, the black box for the antenna is attached to the side of the cover. On the Supercell turbos, the black box will be inside the magnetic starter. One of the wires coming out of the black box is a black wire, and this black wire is the antenna that picks up the signal from your remote control. The next step is to strip the insulation off the antenna wire. I'm going to take a pair of wire strippers and I'm going to strip off a small length of antenna insulation to expose our wire inside. Then we're going to take 10 feet of additional wire, and this can be solid core wire, it can be braided wire. We recommend 22 gauge or thicker wire. In this case, I'm using 20 gauge solid wire, which is a great option, and 10 feet of that wire. Then I will do the same to this wire. I'm going to strip off a little bit of the end of that wire so that they are both exposed. So our next step will be to fish our antenna wire extension up through this opening here in the magnetic starter. To do that, we're going to need to loosen this bolt and nut on the bottom here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to use an adjustable crescent wrench. We're just going to loosen it, which in this case is turning clockwise. And once it's loose enough, then you can use your hand, loosen it down, let that come down. And then you're going to grab your antenna wire, fish it up along the wire that's in there. This is actually the wire for your dust sentry. And fish it up. And once you see it come through into the box, easy tip is to use your wire strippers, reach in there, grab it, and pull a few inches through. If you have a Supercell turbo unit, you will have different looking starter, and it will be this one here. Process is nearly the same. Unscrew, loosen the screws. All right. So unlike the first Supercell, the regular Supercell, the receiver is on the side of the magnetic starter here, not in the lid. And we're finding the black antenna wire like before. On the Supercell turbo unit, the nut that you're going to loosen is on the right side. Unlike the Supercell 1, it's on the left side. And again, you're just going to use an adjustable wrench to loosen it. And then you should be able to use your hand and unloosen. And you will be feeding the wire up through this opening in order to bring your extended wire to your receiver. So our next step will be to attach our two black antenna wires, the one that is a part of the system and the new extension that wire that we installed. You can do this work with either a traditional wire nut, or you can use a lever nut like this Wago clip we have here. And so I open the clips up, and then one wire goes in each side, and I clip it. And on the braided wire, you might just need to twist it a little bit and insert and clip. And just pull, whether you have a traditional wire nut or a Wago clip, just pull on each wire, make sure it's tight and secure, and that step is complete. So now that our wires are attached, we can put everything back the way it was. And so in this case, then I tuck the new wire and the Wago clip alongside the other wires in our box here. Make sure we push everything so nothing pinches or gets in the screws when we put them back. Make sure you look around. Nothing's going to be pinched. Use your screwdriver and tighten your screw. And make sure the case is closed. And on to the next step. So if you don't have your nut up yet, you just need to feed your wire through the nut, screw it back on, and just give it a little snug with your crescent wrench. So it's tight, but don't over tighten. And now you've finished your install inside your magnetic starter. A tip when you're using a remote is to hold the remote up at the level of the starter, pointing it towards the starter, not holding it straight up like this, but pointing it towards the starter, and then pressing your on or off button. This will increase your ability or remote to talk to your Supercell's receiver. Just by adding this extended antenna wire onto your Supercell will significantly increase the performance of your remote control when you use it. If you need to increase your performance more, or if this doesn't fully resolve your remote not turning your Supercell off while it's running, the next step is to extend your antenna wire up above the system to help get above any electromagnetic interference that's occurring. And you can extend it then towards where you are in the shop that you're using your remote control that it's not actively turning it off. This will make it more sensitive to the remote control and will allow the Supercell to turn off using your remote.
If you continue to experience difficulty with your dust collector, call our customer support team at 1-800-732-4065. Or visit oneida-air.com/CST to complete a customer support request.